So we have our stack of folded white pages, and we have our cover page that's folded, and we're gonna make sure that everything is nestled together. Our setup now is a cutting mat and three layers of cardboard taped down just so they don't pop up. And this is gonna be important because we don't wanna poke our table with our awl when we're poking the holes for our stitching on our books. So this tool is called an awl, A-W-L. It's very pokey, please be careful. And here is how we're gonna use it. We're gonna open up our book that we have the nestled pages all together. We're gonna make sure that all of those pages are lined up really well. And then I like to keep it semi, it's like, I don't know, half open, half closed. I don't wanna open it all the way so it's really flat like this because the pages shift around more. So you want it kind of folded still so they're not going to move around back and forth. And then my hands on the outside are making it so that they don't shift around side to side here. So I'm lining it up so that the spine of my book, this is the spine here, is lined up on the cardboard. I'm gonna make three holes. We're gonna be stitching a pamphlet stitch, and for this pamphlet stitch, we're gonna be using three holes. So I want one hole about an inch from the top and about an inch from the bottom. It doesn't have to be exact, but just do your best. And then I want one about in the center. So I'm gonna eyeball it, and that about looks center to me. And what I like to do is kind of twist the awl as I'm poking this hole. And as you can see, the cardboard got the holes poked into it too, rather than the table. Another thing to keep in mind is that we want these holes to be large enough to put our thread through. So make sure that you poke it wide enough that you can see daylight through there. For safety, make sure your fingers are out of the way of this awl. Like I said, it's really sharp and you do not want to poke your finger there. So make sure your fingers are out of the way.